Good evening, YouTube. I have been reconditioning cast iron frying pans for most of my life. This is not the worst one I've ever done. But I was watching a video the other day by Boss of the Swamp. I'll put a link to his video in the description. And he took a frying pan that was not quite in as bad shape as this and soaked it overnight in 60-40 mix of vinegar and water. Not sure offhand which way the 60-40 worked, but so I figured I was going to go at that with the wire brush, but if I don't have to, well then, this is just plain, come on, focus. ...5% vinegar. This is the cheapest one they sell at the grocery store. And I'm just going to put this in straight. I have heard lots of different theories on reconditioning cast iron. A couple of them that don't sit well with me is scrubbing them with salt. We try desperately to keep salt off the steel of our cars. And why would you want to put it on your cast iron? It causes rust. Another one that troubles me is a bunch of guys out there playing with electrolysis. Well, yeah, electrolysis will definitely work to take the rust off. But some of these guys are running it in reverse after to reinstate the metal surface. But they're using things like free machining steel and rebar. Well, free machining steel is called free machining steel because it actually has a small amount of lead in it, which makes it easy to machine. And most rebar is made out of scrap metal and could contain lead, could contain mercury, could contain any of the heavy metals that are not good for you. So I would not suggest using them. But we'll see what this does in the morning. So we're going to shut it down now and come back tomorrow and see what it looks like. Good morning, YouTube. Okay, so this is about 12 hours later. And the discoloration of the vinegar does not look to me to match the amount of rust that was on that frying pan when I put it in. So I think I'm just going to leave it for another few hours and we'll see what it looks like then. All right, so we're about 20 hours in. This is a copper scouring pad. It's the only thing I ever use to scrub my cast iron in the house. The outside is cleaning up pretty nicely. I think that's going to have to soak a little longer. But it says on the back quite clearly, number 5, 8.5 inch, made in USA, but no maker's name. That number 5, 8.5 inch looks an awful lot like Wagner's writing. So this may be one of those unmarked Wagner fry pans. So I think we're going to leave that sit for another night, and we'll get back with you tomorrow. Okay, so yesterday we wound up canning tomatoes and pickled beets and dill pickles and didn't get back out here. So we're about another 40 hours in the solution here. And as you can see, the solution is just about black. The light from the camera is shining in my eyes. Step around this way further. Thank you. There's still a fair bit of buildup on the outside of the pan. But everything seems to be coming off nicely. So I think we're going to keep with the soaking. So we'll let it go another day and see what it looks like then. That's it for now. Okay, so we are about 4 days soaking in this. Quite the buildup of foam on the top. So I think we're going to take this outside and take the garden hose to it and see what we've got. Okay, so we have a bit of rust buildup in the pour spouts. All of that will come off with a wee bit of scrubbing. And we have a fair bit of rust buildup on the outside of the pour spouts. Other than that, it's amazingly clean. So I think we're going to actually use the wire brush on the bench grinder to finish up this stuff. I know a lot of people say you should never do that, but this is not a valuable antique. This is something that's going to be going back into use on a regular basis in the kitchen. So let's take her back inside and get the bench grinder fired up. see where almost all the heavy rust is set off that easily. I'm not pushing really hard on the frying pan into the steel brush, because steel is harder than cast iron. Rust, on the other hand, is harder than steel, so you've got to do a careful balancing act on your pressure. Thank you. little bit of scale buildup here. Still a little bit of scale built up here. But I can live with that. So now this will go into the house, get washed good with soap and water. And yes, I always use soap on my cast iron. The secret in keeping them from rusting is not how you wash them, but how you dry them. Once it's been washed and dried, it goes on the stove just at enough temperature to completely dry it, and then it gets oiled, and then we'll have to do a re-seasoning video as well. But for now, that's it, and thanks for watching.